my name is Katie and thank you so much for joining me. Today I've got a yoga flow for you to improve your strength and form to hopefully help with the rest of your yoga practice. So when you're ready, if you'd like to join me seated on the mat. So first of all, we're going to start with our legs out in front of you. So this is called staff pose, which legs are straight out like a staff. So if it's not comfortable for you to sit in staff pose, you can sit on a cushion or a block, something to keep your legs off the floor. So in staff pose, just think about sitting tall on your sitting bones, pushing your pelvis forwards, straightening the back, perhaps sitting up nice and tall, crown nice and high. And from here, we're going to just think about inhaling and exhaling, getting a nice long neck. So inhale, exhale, inhale. And now we're going to come into butterfly pose. So butterfly pose, just bring the soles of your feet together at a comfortable position away from your hips. So wherever's good for you, if you're here, if you're a little bit closer, that's fine. And then hold on to the feet or hold on to the ankles. And again, sitting up tall on those sitting bones. So think about trying to pull your body towards your feet. So I'm taking a couple of deep breaths there. So inhale and exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Now, knees together, straighten back out into staff. And we're going to move a little bit more in staff pose now. So we're going to inhale the arms all the way up, stretching nice and tall. And exhale, fold over those legs. And do that again, inhale all the way up. And exhale down. And one more time, inhale all the way up, look up towards your hands. And exhale down. Okay, come back into butterfly pose now. So feet together. Think about moving the knees a little bit, getting some movement in your body, get the blood pumping. Each movement you do like this is just going to help you flexibility. So the more you can do, the better. Maybe wiggle around. Again, tall on those sitting bones. Open the chest and inhale and exhale down. Inhale up. Exhale down. Inhale up. Open the chest and then pull the chest as much as you can towards the feet with an exhale. And then back up. Okay, from here, cross your shins, pull your feet in towards your body and roll into lightning pose. So from here, we're just going to think about mobilizing the spine a little bit. So we're going to inhale our right hand up. Oh, feel a lovely side stretch. Inhale deeply and exhale. Right hand to the outside of the left knee, left hand behind you. And we're going to inhale and lengthen. And exhale, twist. Inhale, lengthen. And exhale, twist. Okay, come back to centre. Left hand up now with an inhale. Stretching that side waist. Exhale, left hand to the outside of the right knee, right hand behind you. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, twist. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, twist. And one more time. Inhale, lengthen. And exhale, twist. Okay, so from here, cross your shins again and sit back. Into staff pose. I'm going to do that movement one more time. So we're going to inhale the arms all the way up and exhale forward fold over the knees. Inhale up and exhale forward fold. And one more time. This time we're going to stay in the pose. So we're going to inhale the arms all the way up. Exhale forward fold down. See how far forward you can walk your hands. And then just soften everything down. A good tip here is to think about trying to like kiss your legs. So it allows you to just kind of move quite nice and gently and get a little bit deeper into the pose. Another couple of deep breaths here. Into butterfly pose. soles of the feet together. From here, if it's comfortable for you, think about maybe starting to pull your feet in a little bit closer towards your body. Just increase the hip stretch a little bit more, help you out a little bit. And we're going to inhale, open the chest, rotate the shoulders back and down, neck nice and long. And exhale, forward fold. And exhale. Now from butterfly, if you're comfortable there, you've warmed up and stretched out your hips enough, see if you can pull the feet in a little bit closer. So as close as you can get them to your body, the better. So make sure you're still keeping a nice long back. So adjust your position, move around a little bit, hold on to the feet, inhale. And exhale, forward fold. And inhale. Fold, inhale, and exhale, fold. And we'll stay in the folded position for a while. Soften everything down. If you've got any tension, if you're, you know, tensing up your thighs, just try and release that, let them go. If you've got tension in the shoulders, think about dropping them down. All your muscles, you'll find that you can fold down a little bit deeper, stretch a little bit. Okay. Now come up, cross the shins, roll into lightning pose, and then from here, hands find the floor, and we're going to do some back mobilization again. So this time we're going to do cat cow. So we're going to step back to plank. It's always good to hold a plank, I think, wherever you can in your practice. So any opportunity to quickly hold a plank, drawing the tummy button in towards the spine, is just going to help with your overall strength. So we'll just hold a plank for a second, take a couple of deep breaths, and then lower to the knees. Okay, so I'm on hands and knees now. So hands directly under shoulders, and knees directly under hips, feet in line with the knees. Toes pointing backwards, and from here we're going to inhale, open the chest, arch the back, look forwards, and we're going to exhale, roll everything back, rounding the back into cat, and we're going to inhale, cow, opening the chest, rotate the shoulders back and down, neck nice and long. One more time, see if you can make this your best one. Inhale, cat. Really arch that back. Point the tailbone up towards the sky, open the chest. Drawing the tummy button in towards the spine. And exhale, cow. Oh, cat, sorry. And come back to neutral. From here, we're going to try and do some figure eight movements. So it's the same cat, cow, style of movement with the inhale forward, exhale back, but instead of just moving in that straight line, we're going to be moving around in a figure eight. So I'm going to inhale this way and exhale that way. So I'm going to inhale forwards in a circle, exhale backwards the other way, inhale forwards, exhale. Now try and do the same thing in the opposite direction. So we're going to inhale over my left wrist, moving over to my right wrist, and then exhale, left hip to right hip. Inhale, opening the chest. Exhale, rounding the back. And one more time, inhale. And exhale. Okay, come back to neutral. And we'll wiggle everything out. And from here, we can take our first downward dog. So, hands directly under the shoulders, tuck the toes, come back to plank. Stay there for a second because it's good for us. Deep breath, inhale and exhale. Inhale and then exhale. Slowly, slowly. Think about a string pulling your tailbone up high to the sky. And everything else is just falling into place. So as I've said before, downward facing dog, you want to think about a long line between your tailbone and your hands. Get that first, then straighten out your legs, and then lower to your heels. Okay, so as we're just warming up in this movement, we'll just walk the dog. And then from here, start thinking about slowly walking your feet towards your hands, bending the knees slightly. Inhale the arms all the way up. And exhale down. Very good. So I'm just going to do some more strength building, like repetitive movements here to really help your yoga practice. So I'm going to inhale the arms all the way up. Exhale. Swan dive forward, fold all the way down. Okay, so from here we're going to inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, straighten the back, straighten the legs. And exhale, fold. So what we're going to do from here is practice jumping back to plank. So we're going to do it several times so you'll be able to get used to it. But the key thing when you jump back to plank is to not let your core drop. You've got to try and keep that nice and straight. So we're going to inhale. And we're going to exhale back to plank. So you're not jumping back to this position, you're jumping back to this. So bend your knees and then jump back. Forward fold. Inhale. Exhale. Jump back to plank. Inhale. Back to forward fold. Inhale. And exhale. So in most yoga, it's inhale to prepare, exhale to exert. So we're inhaling to prepare for the pose and then we're exhaling into it. Inhale and exhale. Inhale. Exhale. And then inhale. Inhale. Exhale. So now we're going to do some movements to downward facing dog. So we inhale to prepare in plank pose and we exhale downward dog. Inhale, roll everything back to plank. And exhale. Downward dog. Inhale, plank. And exhale. Downward dog. Inhale, roll back to plank. And exhale. Downward dog. Inhale, back to plank. From here, do practice some chaturangas. So knees down, feet on the top of your feet, pointing your toes backwards. And we're gonna inhale to prepare. And we exhale, lower down, tucking the elbows in towards the ribs. And inhale, cobra. And exhale, come up onto the hands and knees, tuck the toes and push back to downward dog. So do that two more times. So from plank, lower to the knees, come onto the top of the feet, keeping the elbows tucked into the ribs. Exhale down. Inhale, cobra. Tuck the toes. Exhale, downward dog. One more time. Inhale, plank. Lower the knees, come onto the top of the feet. Exhale. Inhale, cobra. Tuck the toes. Exhale, downward facing dog. Walk out the dog a little bit there. You can stay with that movement, or if you think you've got the upper body strength to do it and the core strength, you can do your full chaturanga. So we're gonna come into plank. We're not gonna lower our knees this time, but it's the same movement. And instead of cobra, we're coming into upward facing dog. So we inhale to prepare, exhale, lower down. Inhale, upward dog, and exhale. Downward dog. So we do that again. Inhale, plank. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, upward dog. And exhale, downward dog. So one more time. Inhale, plank. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, upward dog. And exhale, downward dog. And rest a little bit in downward dog now. Walking the dog. Maybe a little bit turbo dog, releasing any tension. Okay, so from here, We're going to raise our right leg up high to the sky. So from downward dog, we're going to inhale and we're going to exhale. Right leg up high, as high as you can get that leg, and then just leave it there. Okay, so just think about wherever your leg is, think about letting it linger. You should be feeling some strain in your standing foot, leg, stretching the back of that hamstring. And then from here, we've pulsed that a few times. So each one of these pulses, you're just increasing your strength and your flexibility. And then bring that right leg down. And we're going to inhale and exhale. Left leg up high. Again, just let that linger, let it hang out there for a while. And then we're going to pulse that left leg. And then bring that back down. And then come back to plank. Lower to the knees and sit back on the heels. And roll your wrists out. Been on your wrists for a while now. They might be feeling a little bit tight. Nice movement from here is to interlace the hands. Push your palms forwards and around the back. Inhale up and exhale. Pull them back behind you. Any sort of shoulder stretches you can do will really help your yoga practice as well. Quite a lot of shoulder mobility for all the fancy looking yoga poses. And then up and release your hands down. Okay, we're just going to do some stepping forward now. So come back onto the hands and knees. Come back to plank. Tuck your tailbone in, tuck your ribs in, and just hold the plank for a second because it's good for us. I'm going to inhale and exhale. Downward dog. So from here, we're going to inhale, our right leg up high. And exhale, right foot in between the hands. Drop the back heel. Inhale, warrior one. And exhale, hands down. Step back to plank. Push. Downward facing dog. And now the left foot goes up high. So we're going to inhale, left foot up. Exhale, left foot in between your hands, lowering the right heel. Inhale, warrior one. I'm going to do a couple more on each side, just to get used to that movement. So hands back down, step back to plank, push to downward facing dog. Inhale, the right foot up high. Exhale, right foot in between your hands, lower the left heel. Inhale, warrior one. And exhale, down. Step back to plank, push to downward dog, inhale the left leg up high, left foot in between your hands with an exhale, drop the right heel, inhale warrior one, and exhale down, step back to plank, push to downward dog, inhale the last time, right leg really high to the sky, high as you can, maybe pulse that a few times. And exhale, right foot in between your hands. Lower the back heel. Inhale, warrior one. We're going to stay here for a little while now. We've warmed up, we're okay. We're going to inhale. Reach your hands up high. Exhale, sink a little bit deeper. Inhale, high. Exhale, sink a little bit deeper. Don't let that knee drop in. Keep it over the heel of the right foot. And inhale up. Stretching up and exhale down. Okay, see if you can hold that for a few more seconds. Back knee nice and high. And exhale down. Step back to plank. Push to downward dog. And we'll do the same on the other side. You're gonna inhale the left leg up high. Pulse that a few times. And exhale, left foot in between your hands. Drop the right heel. Inhale, warrior one. And exhale. So we can inhale, stretch our hands up really high. Stretch our back knee really high. And exhale, sink a little bit deeper into our front knee. Inhale, stretch up.
And exhale, sink. One more time, stretching up. And exhale, sinking deep in. Hips still pointing forward in Warrior One. And stay here for a couple more seconds. And then hands by the floor.
Step back to plank.
Push to downward facing dog. Maybe walk the dog out.
And roll back to plank. Lower to the knees, cross the shins. And sit back. Do a quick stretching now, just to cool everything back down. Both feet out in front of you in star pose. And from here, bring your right foot in, close as you can to your body. Give that a nice hug. And then right foot over the left leg. Bring your left leg in, as gracefully as possible. And then from here, stretch your left hand up high. And then exhale, either your left elbow outside of your right knee, or if that's too much for you, just hug your left knee. Whichever is better for you. Right hand behind you. We inhale, lengthen the spine, and exhale, twist. A couple more of those. Inhale, lengthen, and exhale, twist. Come back to centre. Stretch your legs out again and do the same on the other side. So left leg comes in, give that a nice hug. And then left foot outside of the right thigh. Bring your right foot in, close to your glutes. And we're going to inhale, lengthen. And exhale, twist. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, twist. And one more time. Inhale, lengthen. And exhale, twist. Undo the legs. Come back to cobbler's pose. One last time. Inhale, open the chest, and exhale down. Thank you so much for practicing with me today. I hope you enjoyed that, and I would hope to see you again soon. Thank you. And please, you know, if you're interested in seeing more of my videos, please subscribe. And if you'd like to comment as well, let me know what you'd like to see next time. Thank you very much. Namaste.